Hello friends, welcome to Maluka IAS. Myself, Lashwan Singh Maluka, would be discussing an important topic of paper 4 mains, environmental ethics. The question that can come on environmental ethics can be in the form, for example, why do we need environmental ethics? Justify with the help of various example. Firstly, and the second question that can come out of it is, also bring about the various ways in which the conflict between development and environment can be solved. This can be a question, one of the important questions that can be found. So tackling the first part of the question, why do we need environmental ethics, and justifying it with the help of example. The most important aspect starting directly from the answer is, we need environmental ethics because we cannot stop development. Stopping development would be ethically wrong. It would be ethically wrong if we stop development. So what is important is there is a thin line of difference between developmental ethics and environmental ethics. As a human being has to continue progress, the development has to take place. Therefore, ethically it would be wrong if we stop development. So therefore, important is to have development. Therefore, development is the need of the hour because it has to sustain the human being. Along with it, what becomes important is not only the human beings has to be sustained, but other things in the planet have also to be taken into consideration. Therefore, what is important is sustainable development. The need of the hour is not only development, but sustainable development. It is only in this context that Article 21 of the Constitution says right to free and fair environment. Free and fair environment becomes very much important. But on the other hand, if we do not differentiate between the two, there is a conflict. And it is that to overcome the conflict, the role of the administrator comes. Administrators can be an IAS officer or any other administrator can be there. The judiciary can be there interfering. I'll give you certain examples of it. For example, the issue was there in Singrur. The Supreme Court interfered that we have to stop the mining over here. Why? Because the Supreme Court indirectly said that it is the religious issues of the community that are involved. When the religious issues are involved or the religious ethics of the community are involved, you cannot do overdevelopment over here because the religious issues are getting affected. First example. Second example, I'll tell you about Jammu and Kashmir. In Jammu and Kashmir, the encroachment was taking on the forest land. Therefore, that forest land encroachment was hurting the sentiments of the wildlife that was staying over there. Therefore, the High Court of Jammu and Kashmir came out with a conclusion that we have to stop this encroachment, and the reason that was there was that it involved animal ethics that was in there. So animal ethics should not be hurt. Therefore, we have to stop this encroachment of the land. Third example I'll tell you is about Delhi. In Delhi, a PIL was filed that for we have to have a clean air. The clean air becomes very much important, in which the Supreme Court said that replace diesel vehicle with the CNG vehicles. Diesel vehicle has to be replaced with CNG vehicles. The reason given was that the environmental ethics are being involved. Another reason can be the personal ethics were being involved. Another reason can be the social ethics was involved. It is just because of this that the various administrators have to interfere in one way or in another way. Therefore, the role of the administrator comes that there is no conflict between development on the one hand and sustain on environment on the other hand. The second part of the question is bring about various ways in which the conflict between the two can be overcome. The first important thing that is there, we have to plan for the development. Plan for whom we are making the development, and in this context it becomes very much important that we involve the people, we involve the stakeholders. So therefore, firstly, we have to plan for the development, and secondly, involve the stakeholders who are participants, who are, for example, within the development phase, and for so that the participants who are there, they were fully aware. The third step would come, create awareness among them. The awareness principle is very much important, because then only those participants, then only then stakeholders would be in a better position to know what will be the positive effect, impact of that development would be there. Then, while development has to be made, it has to be very clear that strict implementation of the environmental laws has to be made. All the environmental laws have to be implemented in a better way, and that is what shows the ethical work culture. When you are implementing a particular law in a particular way, that reflects that the bureaucracy, that reflects that the administrators, that reflects that persons who are implementing that project are having an ethical work culture, and that becomes important. And that also involves that you are timely implementing of the project. So this is the way timely implementation of the project, proper monitoring, proper evaluation, and involving of the community, so that it becomes important for them that if they know whether the project will be in a positive for them or the project will be in a negative, having a negative effect on them. So this is the way you can write the examples on environmental ethics. Friends, what is important in the ethics is, with the same knowledge, a student can be in a position to score approximately 70 marks. But when you add examples into it, for example, I told you the examples of Odisha, I told you the examples of Jammu and Kashmir, I told you the examples of, for example, Delhi, that 70 will become 120 when you write in a proper order. You cannot stop development. You cannot just write an example bookish answer for the ethics. You have to write something that is very much practical. Why we need development, and that should not be contradictory, because development is the need of the hour, and it is from here that you have to start with the question. Thank you very much, friend, for watching this video. I hope that this particular topic, small topic on environmental ethics, would be helpful in your UPSC means. Thank you very much.